God. Praise God. Praise God. All right. So I'll quickly just do a short recap. So day one, we began to look at the having an understanding of the Feast of Pentecost. And in that regard, we uncovered three key things about Pentecost. One, that Pentecost symbolizes fruitfulness. It comes with the spirit of fruitfulness. Again, if you remember, the other, the real original Hebrew, Shavuot, it is the Feast of First Fruits, right? And I say the three major feasts of Israel, they had to do with harvest, right? So you only harvest what has been born, what is fruitful. It's only out of your fruitfulness that you begin to collect the harvest. So Pentecost speaks about fruitfulness. And indeed, I want to say again that everyone on this platform tonight, there is no basis for barrenness. There is no basis for fruitlessness. And therefore, I ignite that again in the spirit tonight on this platform, that fruitfulness comes upon each one of us from tonight. You will bear fruit in every area of your life because that is the season we have stepped into. Praise God. And the second thing you find about Pentecost is that it is a season of first, which speaks of divine priority. And so we are going to be placing premium on the agenda of the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. And the last thing we spoke about on the first day was that Pentecost speaks about self-giving. All right. So we begin to yield ourselves and become the first fruits in our families, first fruits, you know, in our offices, in our business environments. We become first fruits in our communities, in our nations, because the first anticipates the rest. As we become the first, we will then be able to open the door for others to follow through. Praise Jesus. And yesterday we began to zero in on the book of Acts of the Apostles as we went into the new covenant to look at Pentecost and the Feast of Pentecost. And we started talking about Acts of the Apostles chapter 2 from verse 1 and verse 3. It said, when the day of Pentecost was fully come, when it was fully come, praise God, when it was fully come, we began to x-ray that the coming in the fullness of Pentecost also heralded the coming of the Holy Spirit of God. And the coming of the Holy Spirit activated harvest. And of course, on that first day, as Peter ministered, 3,000 souls were saved. And we moved on from there and began to look at the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 1, particularly verse number 8. And that's where we are going to be zeroing. And so yesterday, we began to say, he said to them, but ye shall receive power. So don't bother about any other thing. The answer is in the power. Praise God. The answer is in the power. Whatever else you, whatever bothers you, whatever are the conflicts and contradictions that may be around you, Jesus said on that day, but you shall receive power. But you shall receive power. On the contrary, you shall receive power. That's what he was saying. It doesn't matter what it was. Samson may be faced up with a lion, hungry lion, that is about to tear him up. But you shall receive power. And so what happened? The Bible will tell us that the power, the Holy Spirit, or the power of the Holy Spirit came upon him mightily. The Spirit of God will come upon him mightily. It did not matter any situation, whether it was Prophet Elijah or Prophet Elisha, the power of the Holy Spirit was made manifest to take care of every need they had around them. So the answer is in the power of God. And I'll be talking a bit more about that tonight. And I said something which I consider very important yesterday. And that is this. Listen, my friends. With the power of God, you can move anything. And with the power of God, nothing can move you. Praise God. You move anything with the power of God. So if you have the power of God filling up your life, you move everything, but you cannot be moved. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You cannot be moved. So in this season, I want you to know, I was citing something that yesterday, and I was saying, listen, friend, ultimate power. He said, if I confront you, you fall. If you confront me, you follow the Holy Spirit. We can boldly stand today and face up with anything in creation and say, if I confront you, you fall. If you confront me, you fall. Why? Because you shall receive power. You shall receive power. Praise God. Somebody type on the chat, I receive power. I receive power. Just type it out there. I receive power. I receive power. And so we say tonight, we're going to zero in fully. Just keep typing it. I receive power. So we say tonight, we're going to zero in on Acts chapter 1, verse 8. And we said, there are three things in Acts chapter 1, verse 8. One is what you will receive. Two is what you will become. And three is what you will impact. He said, you shall receive power when the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you will be witnesses, right? Witnesses. In Jerusalem, in Judea, in Samaria, and to the utmost parts of the earth. So, three things that are locked there: what you will receive, what you will become when you receive what you receive, and then what you will affect or impact. Praise God. So, that's where we are going to continue tonight, right? I have already read the scripture. So, I'd like to talk to you, first of all, about what you will receive. What he say, you will receive something, and then you will become something, and then you will impact something, right? So we take the point number one, what you will receive, what you will receive. What did he say they will receive? He say you will receive power. Somebody type their power. He say you will receive power, power, power. If you go to the original Hebrew, he say you receive power, dunamis, dunamis. Do not miss. You will receive power. And this is how my amplified version explains power here. Power meaning do not miss. This is how he explains. He said, but you shall receive power, meaning ability, efficiency, and might. Jesus. Ability, efficiency, and might. That's do not miss. Power. He said, you will receive power. So what I want to first of all do tonight, because if you come into an understanding of what Jesus says we will receive, you will then walk in fullness of life. He says you will receive power. You are not permitted to walk without power, having received the Holy Spirit. If you receive the Holy Spirit, you receive power. He says, if the same Spirit which raised Jesus Christ from the dead dwells in you, that same power will quicken your mortal body. It will literally transform your mortal body. You will begin to do things that otherwise you wouldn't have been able to do on your own. Why? Because you are plugged into the current of power. Rakayaba, Jetoria. I'd like you to keep typing the power, power. Power, dunamis, that's what we shall receive. Praise God. And I want you to see something. I want to show you the three dimensions of power so you begin to understand what Jesus has unlocked for us. I cannot walk less than what he has given me. I can't walk below that. I cannot. He said, I will receive power. I will show you three dimensions of power you find in scripture for the believer. One is dunamis. Two is what is called kratos. The other is exousia. I will explain them to you. Dunamis, kratos, exousia. I'd like to explain power to you so that next time when you confront a situation, you know what is backing you up and you can pull from your armor. You can dole out Ariako Sufrenikaba Rentosha Antayaba Rico Cemento Andriakada.
Hallelujah.
I speak over everyone here. You Hallelujah. Receive power. Power Amen. To confront, power Amen. To overcome.
In Hallelujah. Kalaya,
power to change things. Praise God. I sense the Holy Ghost moving forth. You will receive power. He said, not Amen. By mind, nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord of hosts. You receive power in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. He said you receive power. Now, I'll show you one scripture and I will explain these three levels or dimensions of power so that you may walk in truth. He said if you continue to know the truth, you will be set free by the truth. If you come into a revelation of what is available to you, then you walk in liberty. You walk in freedom. Nothing binds you anymore. Praise God. Now, look at this. I'd like to show you a scripture in Ephesians 1, very popular scripture, Ephesians 1, verses 19 to 21. You use this to understand the three dimensions of power. Now, this is what the scripture says in the Amplified. And so that you can know and understand what is the immeasurable and unlimited and surpassing greatness of his power. That's the first time we see power there. The surpassing greatness of his power. So number one is the greatness of his power. I will explain what that means. And he goes on and say, in and for us who believe, as demonstrated in the working of his mighty power. That is another one. So one is the greatness of his power, is a dimension of power. The next is the working of his mighty strength or power. That's another dimension of power. And then he goes on, he says, which he exalted in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his own right hand in heavenly places. Look at 21. Far above all rule and authority and power and dominion and every name that is named, above every title that can be conferred, not only in this age and in this world, but also in the age and world which are to come. All right, so let me break it down. You can check this out in the original Hebrew. So I will show you three powers or dimensions of power that are mentioned in this one scripture. All right, so in verse 18, we hear about the greatness of his power. Oh, Shamaya, the greatness of his power. This is dunamis. The power here is dunamis. Dynamic power or dynamite power. That's what it is. It is the same word that is used in Acts of the Apostles 1:8 when he say you shall receive power. So that power there is dunamis. It is the power that is used to work miracles. It is the power that carries special abilities. This is the power that is used to alter situations. Can I tell you, my friends? Jesus says you will receive dunamis. Dunamis is the power that is used to alter situations. You speak to a barren person and say you will be with a child, and you see that situation turned. You see things in your family and you don't like the way they are going. And by dunamis, you can change them. It is a special ability to change things that otherwise would have gone in a particular order. Praise God. I'd like you to type again, I receive power. I receive power. I receive power. I speak to your spirit today. You have dunamis. You have dunamis. I stir up the power of God in you. From this day, understand you have special abilities. Ability to alter what is, Sante, to change them to what you desire. That is what dunamis does. Dunamis transforms. Dunamis changes the course of things. Dunamis interrupts the flow of things. If you check things flowing in a particular order in your life, in your family, and you don't want that, what do? Activate dunamis. Alter the situation. You shall receive power. Dunamis. Praise God. Nekabashanamalia. He said you receive power. And that is dunamis. Number two power we have there, he speaks about his mighty power. His mighty power, that's Kratos. Kratos is ruling or dominion power. It is the same word you find in Genesis 1:26, where he says, "And they shall have dominion. They shall have dominion." So Kratos is dominion power. That is what Paul calls here his mighty power. Kratos, his mighty power. It is the same word used in Romans 5:17 when he says you shall reign in life. Oh, Frenagabaya. He says you will reign in life. You will have dominion. You will have governmental authority. Listen, Kratos is used for territorial dominion. Kratos helps you to control an environment. Kratos is what you use for what I was referring yesterday as invasion. Amantoyaba, likayama legede, zizania kabalia. Kratos puts you in charge of the atmosphere where you are praying, of the environment where you are praying. Enko shikaba, I speak to your spirit once more. You receive his mighty power. You receive his mighty power. Kratos is activated in you. You rule over territories. You know what? That is what God assigns us as a scepter, to sit on thrones in our environment and begin to bear rule over those environments. Praise God. You will receive, you receive Kratos. All right? The final one, it speaks of there in 21, it says power. Power. Power there is exousia. Exousia, or delegated authority. Exousia. That is what you find in Matthew 28 and verse 18, the same word. All and the earth have been given to me. That is delegated authority. It's called exousia. Listen. When you confront Satan, sometimes you may not have, you know, the level of wisdom because he's been around for some time, right? He may appear like he's greater than you, but you know what? You activate exousia, exousia. That you will begin to tap into the same power that rules heaven and rules earth because it's delegated to you to exercise. Sanamadia, kuzana malagada. I like to show you something. In Luke's Gospel, chapter 10, verse 19, it says, I give unto you power over all the power of the enemy. let me break it down for you. He said, I give unto you power. That first power there is exousia. And when he says the power of the enemy, he refers to dunamis. You know what this means? It means that the enemy has ability, but you have authority. All right. So if you want to render it in plain English, it says, I give unto you exousia over dunamis. I give unto you delegated authority over the abilities of the enemy. Jesus. I give you exousia over dunamis. I give you authority over ability. I give that to you. You know what? This is what it means. You will now see the size of the devil. The devil has ability, I have authority. But can I tell you, from what we have read, I also have ability. Because by Acts of the Apostles 1:8, I have dunamis. So I have what the devil has, I have what he does not have. I have dunamis, I have kratos, I have exousia, he has only dunamis. And so, in two, three cases, I am better. In three cases, I am better. I am better. I am better. Can you type there? I am better. I am better. I am better. So the enemy only can exercise ability, but I have ability. I have authority. I have dominion. I have all of that. Praise God. Praise God. So let's start wrapping this up. So in Acts of the Apostles 1:8, Jesus says, you shall receive power. And in parentheses says, ability, efficiency, and might. These are the three things you will receive. Ability, efficiency, and might. So when we come to Pentecost, the power of the Holy Spirit that was released upon us on Pentecost, the day you received the baptism in the Holy Spirit, you received three things locked into the power of God that came upon your life. One is ability. Next is efficiency. The other one is might, might, might. That's what you receive. You receive all three locked into the same package. Now, so what is ability? Ability refers to special skills and competencies. It can be physical. It can be mental. It can be spiritual. You have spiritual ability, mental ability, physical ability. You are empowered with supernatural ability. You know what? The day Elijah started running and went into the gate of Jezreel before Ahab, even though Ahab had started before him, what was happening? He had received ability. He had received ability to do what physically he could not have done. When Elisha begins to see or hear the conversations that go on in the bedroom of the kings of the enemies, right? Enemy nations. He had special ability, special insight, special hearing in the Spirit of God. And I speak over you tonight. Therefore, you receive ability. The package you received in the Holy Ghost included special ability, special skills, and empowered with the supernatural. Sometimes you begin to find yourself doing things that on your own you could not have done them. You begin to have certain degrees of wisdom and insight that on your own you will never have had them. You know why? It is ability stirring up inside you, Mante Shabalaya. I stir that up. I ignite ability within you tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ, say amen. You know what the scripture says? In the book of Job, okay, 32 verse 8, it said the spirit in man. There's a spirit in man. And the inspiration of the Almighty gives him understanding. So you begin to get into certain levels and realms of understanding that normal men don't have. You know why? Because there's a spirit in man. Because there's something God has put in you. Because there's a power of the Holy Ghost which gives you ability. Koma shamalabaya. Le kamalaba. Keep typing that I have ability, because I need you to be your own prophet, to speak this over your life, because that's the package you have received in the Pentecost feast as the outpouring of the Holy Ghost came upon us. Ability, ability. I have ability. I have ability. Praise God. The next thing he speaks about, efficiency. Efficiency is to be able to do more with less. That's what efficiency is. Doing more with less. That's what it means. It means producing something without wasting material. It means creative excellence. Creative excellence. Amali Kosi Franaya. It is the mantle of Bezaleel and Aholia. When you receive the Holy Spirit, you receive the mantle of excellence, the mantle of creativity. Kamo Shilaba. Rianto. That's why you learn how to do things in a correct order. You just say the right words at the right time. Amaye kaba. You just have that uncanny wisdom to cause you to do things that are appropriate for the time, without waste of time, without waste of material. Somebody say, I have the spirit of excellence. Somebody type it there. Excellence, 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 excellence. Because that's the package we received on Pentecost when the Holy Ghost was poured out. You receive the spirit of excellence. And finally, it says might. Might is a special supernatural ability. With might, we work miracles. With might, we work miracles. Do you know that part of that package is for you to work miracles? As Peter received the baptism in the Holy Spirit, the next time he was walking to the temple, what does he do? He raises a man who was lame. He picks him up and says, what? He says, silver and gold I don't have, but what I have I give to you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. What is that? Might. Might at work. Might at work. So you can walk back into your environment and begin to cause things that be not to become. You begin to call things into effect. You begin to transform situations. Praise God. That is might. That is the package that God has given us in the Holy Spirit. He says, you shall receive power. All right. So let's move on. So what do you receive? Power. I needed to take the time to break these things down so that the next time you think of power, you know what the total package you have received. You have received dunamis. You have received kratos. You've received exousia. What else do you need? What else do you require? What else do you require to reign in life? You have it all put together. Praise Jesus. That's what you have received. Power, 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 power. I will wrap up. He said, what do you receive? What we receive? We receive power. All right? What do we become? He said, we will become witnesses. Witnesses. A witness is a martyr. A witness is a record bearer. Now look at 1 John chapter 1, verse 1. Look at what it said. It said, that which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, which we have looked upon, and our hands have handled, of the word of life. Verse 2 says, for life was manifested, and we have seen it, and bear witness, and shew unto you that eternal life, which was with the Father, and was manifested unto us. God is calling us to become witnesses. With the anointing and the power of the Holy Ghost, we become witnesses of what we have seen. We become the display board God uses to display what he is, who he is. We become that display board. We are witnesses. Somebody type in there, I am a witness. I am a witness. I am a witness. Now, don't want to waste time on that. I want to uncover for you what I've called the four manifestations of an anointed witness in the marketplace. All right? The four manifestations of an anointed witness in the marketplace. I'd like to just uncover that for you. If you want to be a witness in your place of work, in your business environment, in your environment, your street, your road, your community, these are the four manifestations of becoming an anointed witness. And I thought this would be useful. I have brooded over this, and for me, if you want to stand out as a witness, a proper and accurate witness for Jesus, we must see these four elements in your life. One is servanthood. Oh, Shanama. Servanthood. If you can type in there, I am a servant. The best way to demonstrate that the power of Jesus is in you is to serve your environment. Praise God. It is to serve. It is not to ride on a high horse. It is to bring yourself down and serve others. Jesus said to them, anyone who wants to be great among you, let him be the servant of all. That is how they know. If you have the spirit of service, people will recognize that you carry your Jesus with you. All right? You don't sit aloof. You want to help. You want to be of assistance to people. That is one way to demonstrate being an anointed witness. The anointing causes you to serve. Can I tell you something? The power of the Holy Ghost that comes upon us, it is the power for service. We use it to serve. If you are not serving, you are not anointed. If you are not serving, you are not anointed. The true validation of your anointing is that you serve. You are helping. You are lending a helping hand. You are lifting men. You are denying yourself stuff to be able to build up others. You have to serve. That is one manifestation in the marketplace that you are anointed. You must be a server. Number two manifestation of an anointed witness is excellent. You can't do things shabby and you say you are anointed. If you are anointed, it will be the same spirit upon Basileel and Aholia. It will be the same that will be at work in you. You must do things exceptionally well. Exceptionally well. That is how you prove that you have the spirit of God. You are anointed. All right? The way they were devising skillful things, that's how you devise skillfulness. How did David rule? David ruled by the integrity of his heart and the skillfulness of his hands. 78. I think verse 72. He said, David led them according to the integrity of his heart and the skillfulness of his hand. All right? So an anointed with don't do shabby work. Your work has to stand out. Your work has to, that is how you become a witness with your excellence. You can make people turn around. If you're a high performer, people will turn around and want to find out what is behind you. And that's what gives you a voice in the marketplace. Praise God. Number three is ethics and character. That is another manifestation of an anointed witness in the marketplace. You must have a character. You know, I read a story the other day. A man called Sir Arthur Conan, he did something. He wanted to play a joke, send a practical joke to people. So there were 12 prominent men in the city where he was, 12 well-known people. Well-respected people. This is what he did. He sent them a message and they didn't know it was a joke. What did the message say? He said, flee at once. All is discovered. Flee at once. All is discovered. Guess what? In 24 hours, all 12 respected men, they packed out of town. In other words, they had skeletons to hide in their cupboards, as it were. But Samuel stood on that day and said, I call heaven to bear witness. If there is any man that I've defrauded of anything, let him come out and speak. Yeah? Yeah? That is the strength of character. I'd like to say to you, if you must be an anointed witness in your environment, you need to have strength of character. The final one is supernatural manifestations. Things cannot just go ordinary in your life. All right? There are things that are freely given. There are certain manifestations that we want to see around you. You can speak and things are transformed in the workplace. That's how it works. You speak and it comes to pass. That's how it works. Because you have might at work in you. You have might at work in you. The power to do the supernatural. These are the four manifestations. So what will you receive? You will receive power. What will you become? You will become a witness. And finally, what will you affect? You will affect your world. He said, you'll be witnesses to me in Jerusalem, in all Judea, in Samaria, and to the uttermost part of the earth. You will have to affect your environment. You have to affect cities. Yesterday and the day before, we started talking about how Jesus returned from the temptation in the wilderness in the power of the Holy Spirit. He returned. He returned in the power of the Holy Spirit. And where did he return to? He moved with that power into his Galilee. Koma Shabana. He invaded Galilee, literally, with the power of the Holy Spirit. And I want to challenge you. God wants you to return. Return to your place of birth. Return to the workplace. Return tomorrow to the same environment, full of the power of the Holy Spirit. Praise God. You are to affect cities. You are to affect your word. I will close, therefore. I'd like to challenge every one of us as we begin to go into the place of prayer. Learn to begin to soak up the power of the Holy Spirit. Learn to stand and minister in the Holy Ghost until you are brimming over. Kambro, Shina, Kayaba, Lento, Subrene, Keteshka, Lamianto, Sobe, Kamiantaya, Le Sonteni, Katunza, Branataya, Inkashante, Kaba, Riento, Sofrono, Kotoboje, Riantalaba, until you pray yourself full and come out in manifestation of the power and the workings of the Holy Spirit. The Lord spoke to me this night, and this is what will begin to happen. He said, as Saul came into the company, among the company of prophets and the prophesied. That is on this platform tonight. As we ignite the aura of the Holy Spirit, the atmosphere of the Holy Spirit, there are some of you that will prophesy for the first time. There are some of you that will receive a fresh infilling of the power of the Holy Ghost. There are some of you, your eyes will pop open in the Spirit. Your ears will pop open in the Spirit. Your discernment will be heightened. And crematoshia. Can you unmute your system? And let's begin to minister in the Holy Ghost. Sontaya, Lalika, Magolo, Salagada.